हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग। माय नेम इज़ दिनेश कुमार एंड आई एम वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग रायतवाड़ा यूनिवर्सिटी। इन टुडेज सेशन वी विल एक्चुअली डिस्कस द वेरियस मोड्स ऑफ हीट ट्रांसफर और वेरियस हीट ट्रांसफर मैकेनिज्म्स प्रेजेंट इन एनवायरमेंट अराउंड अस। ओके, सो बिफोर कमिंग ऑन टू मेन टॉपिक मोड्स ऑफ हीट ट्रांसफर, व्हाट वी विल आई वांट टू डिस्कस इज आई वांट टू डिस्कस टू वेरियस टू कॉमन टर्म्स। वन टर्म इज थर्मोडायनेमिक्स एंड द सेकेंड वन इज योर हीट ट्रांसफर, बिकॉज बोथ ऑफ दीज सब्जेक्ट्स थर्मोडायनेमिक्स एंड हीट ट्रांसफर आर डायरेक्टली कनेक्टेड टू द हीट एनर्जी। ओके, so what could be the difference between these thermodynamics and heat transfer? Okay, so actually when we are talking about thermodynamics, it is kind of a basic subject, okay, where we will learn about the various thermal processes or heat energy processes in case of equilibrium states. But when we are talking about heat transfer, subject heat transfer or term heat transfer, we are not only talking about only thermodynamic states or equilibrium states, we are talking about system as a whole, where we can also discuss the transient state or various kind of losses which are present in your actual environment conditions. So in your subject heat transfer, we actually discuss the real situations, how your heat transfer takes place in your real situations. Okay, now moving forward to your actual topic of this session, is which is heat transfer. Now what is heat transfer? Heat transfer is the process of transfer of heat from higher temperature system to a lower temperature system. Okay, in case of thermodynamic system, heat transfer is the movement of heat across the boundary of the system due to temperature difference between the system and surrounding. So what happens is that heat transfer only takes place if there is a temperature difference between two places, two objects, or two between system and surrounding. If there is no temperature difference between these two between system and surrounding, that means that your system is in thermal equilibrium with your surrounding. So no heat transfer will take place in this condition. Okay, so heat always moves from warmer place to colder place. Okay, heat objects in cooler room will cool to room temperature. Cold objects in warmer room will heat up to room temperature. Okay, so last two statements is the example of your heat transfer. Okay, if we place the hot objects in cooler room, what will happen is our hotter object will actually transfer heat to your room environment. Okay, and when we are placing a warmer cold objects in warmer room, what is happening is your warmer room is transferring heat to your cold object, and your temperature of your object will come into thermal equilibrium with your room temperature. Okay, so now next question which comes to our mind is that what are the various types of heat transfer methods which takes place in our surrounding environments. Okay, so there are three ways of heat transfer. Okay, the first one is conduction, then next one is convection, and the next one is your radiation. What is actually conduction? Conduction is the process in which heat flows in a body is achieved by the transfer of the momentum of individual atoms or molecules without mixing, or transfer of heat from one atom to another within an object by direct contact with each other. Okay, so what is conduction? Conduction is heat transfer which takes place due to vibrational or translational motion of molecules in that particular medium. Now the flow of heat is dependent on the transfer of vibrational energy from one molecule to another, and in case of matter, the movement of free electrons. Okay, the two mechanisms explain how heat is transferred by the conduction, that is by vibration and particle collision. Okay, conduction through solids occur by combination of the two mechanisms. Heat is conducted through the stationary fluids primarily by molecular collisions. Okay. Now, if we have to understand the whole phenomenon of conduction by lattice vibration or particle collisions, okay. So, if you look at your screen, what you can see see is the example of your whole heat transfer by conduction process, conduction by lattice vibration or particle collisions. Okay. So, if you look at your screen, the whole process of heat transfer by conduction can be understood very clearly. Okay. So, what is happening here is that we are representing your metallic elements or metallic object in terms of network of various atoms. If you look at your picture number 2, what is happening is your hot particles are represented with the red color, and your cold particles are represented with yellow color or white color. Okay, so what happens is that your hot particle contains your some amount of energy. This energy will force your particle to move towards your cold particle, and this, when they collide, these two particles collide with each other, what happens is that your hotter particle will transfer your some amount form of energy or some amount of energy to this cold particle, and at some stage what will happen is that these two particles come into come at the similar energy level, and this type of phenomenon or this method of heat transfer will take place in whole element or whole object, metallic object. Okay, so this is your example of your conduction. When you heat a metal strip at one end, the heat travels to the other end. Okay, as you heat the metal, particles vibrate, vibrations are passed along the metal, and so is the heat. We call this whole phenomenon of transfer of heat from one end of your metal to metallic object to another end of metallic object with the help of mechanical vibrations or lattice vibration, your conduction. Okay. Now this is your Fourier law of heat conduction. Now what is your how do we calculate the amount of heat transfer or rate of heat transfer through an metallic object? Now this can be done with the help of your Fourier law of heat conduction. I will not go into detail in this session. I will only touch the basics or basic formula or basic equation which is used in your Fourier law of heat conduction. Okay, what is your Fourier law of heat conduction? Your Fourier law of heat conduction says that heat flux or flow of heat per unit area and per unit time at a point in a medium is directly proportional to temperature gradient at that particular point. This equation also tells us that the rate of heat transfer through the wall increases when the temperature or difference between the left and right hand surface increases. Okay. The wall surface area increases, the wall thickness reduces. Okay? So, if we are reducing the thickness of your metallic object, the rate of heat transfer through this will also, this will increase. Okay, if we are increasing the area of wall surface, this will also result in increase in rate of heat transfer. Okay, if there is temperature, higher temperature difference between two ends of the wall or metallic object, then it will also result in increased heat transfer rate. Okay, now what is the general equation of Fourier law of heat conduction? Your general equation is Q equal to minus Ka T hot minus T cold divided by L. Okay, So where Q is your rate of heat transfer and K is your thermal conductivity and A is your surface area of the wall and T hot and T cold are the temperature of the both ends of your wall, okay, both sides of your wall. Now L is your thickness of your wall. So with the help of this equation, what happens is how various factors affect the rate of heat transfer or heat flux is clearly visible. Okay, this is